Finally, we can resume. And now we have Anita Zniżewska, and she will talk about fiberwise linear Poisson structures related to WSTAR algebras.
Yes,
and you have until 20 past.
Thank you very much. So at the beginning, I would like to thank organizers to invitation and to possibility to be in Vienna. I spent quite nice week here, and I'm happy that I can participate in this nice meeting. So today I would like to show you some elements of a few papers which we have written together with my colleagues from Białystok, so Grzegorz Jakimowicz and Anatol Kociewicz. This is the main paper. And in previous one, which was written with Kirill Martensi, we consider some structures, but on related to this subject, but only in finite dimensional case. And general knowledge of this matter you can find in the book of Kirill Martensi, General Theory of Algebraic and the Algebraics, and article of Anatology and Topographio, Banachli Poisson spaces and reduction. And my talk is some kind of maybe even continuation in some sense of talk of Daniel Benfica, so we start them with the same objects. So the knowledge from Daniel Benfica talk is very useful for my part. Okay, in this subject, which I will speak today, we combine two huge theory, two more, even three. It's groupoid theory and WSTAR algebra theory. And we already know that when we think, when we speak about WSTAR algebra, we can think about algebra of bounded operators of some Hilbert space. So, here we have a full functional analysis, so the third huge theory. Okay, we start from definition of groupoid. I suppose that today already all of you know what is groupoid, so I will not repeat it very precise, but only to fix the notation. I notice source and target map as S and T, and groupoid product by M, which is given by composable pairs, and identity section by Epsilon, inverse map by Iota. We of course know that these maps should satisfy the following condition in order to have the weight structure. We already have heard at the beginning of this week that groupoid is a small category with invertible morphism, and the most easy example is the group. Group is of course a groupoid under one point identity of group. The next very important example for me is groupoid, is per groupoid. This one is also already known, so for any not empty set, we have to find source and target map as projection on coefficients of this product. And these maps are even here, so I will not read this. And the next very important example for me is gauge groupoid of principal bundle. This groupoid we can obtain taken the principal bundle P with GS of total space is P, fiber is G, and the base is M. When we take the Cartesian product of P and take the relation, equivalence relation, which is done by this formula. So as usual for principal bundle, we have write free action of group G on manifold P, and then on the set of equivalence classes of this relation, which is the node by this bracket is notation of spell or notation. So, equivalent classes of this relation, we can define source map as projection to the second component, so the target as projection to that one, so given by P. So here we can also think that we have the source of this pair is only one equivalence class of element Y with respect to the action of group G on M. The same for T. Composition for elements of these equivalence classes is even here. So we can compose two elements of this when we have such element of G for which multiplying y by right hand side by element G, we obtain that one. So that means that the equivalence classes here on the base for R and Y are the same. Then product is defined. This formula, identity section is given. That and inverse map change the order in this pair. And this is groupoid, which is denoted this symbol over P divided by G, which is isomorphic with M. So the next point is W star algebra. What is W star algebra? We have already heard during the lecture of Daniel Bentica. So for me, important is definition. So we have at least three definitions of W star algebra, but for me, the most important is that one, that the W star algebra is such C star algebra. For which there exists a Banach space, which we denote by M star, such that a dual to it is equal the original one. And for W star algebra, by definition, there exists unique such Banach algebra, and it is called Redouane space. As we already know, thinking about W star algebra, we can think about the algebra of bounded operators, if you wish. We, in W star algebra, we find some special elements. So one of them is projection. So what is projection? Orthogonal projection or orthogonal projector. When it is self-adjoint and equals to the square of itself, and the set of these projections we denote by L of M, and here I have some remark that this set of projections form the lattice of projections, and this is complete lattice. This lattice is quite important for the other considerations. So the interesting is that for my studies about this matter, this lattice was the first subject in this area. So the second special element in W star algebra is partial isometry. We already also know what is partial isometry. By partial isometry, we call element U from W star algebra, and if U star or U star U is projection, and we already know that from today's lecture of Daniel Pepica, that the element U star U we can call initial projection, and U star final projection. So about partial isometry U, we can think in groupoid, because we already know that partial isometries form groupoid. We can think like arrow between two projections. So the set of objects are given by projections, and arrows are partial isometries. But we already know that partial isometries form groupoid, but for my consideration, the most important is the groupoid of partially invertible elements of W star algebra. So in order to define the structure of this groupoid, I have to say what is right and left, right and left support of any elements of W star algebra. It's denoted by X. So this is projections in M such that this equal this element are equals. And of course, if element X is self-adjoint, then support left and right are equal. And the special thing which is characteristic only for W star algebra, not for C star algebra, is polar decomposition of any element of this algebra. So about polar decomposition we also already have heard. So for any element, we have such partial isometry and such positive element of this algebra, such that U star and U star U are right and left support of this element. Next, by G PNP, we denote the group of all invertible elements in W subalgebra PNP. This is subalgebra in which the projection P is identity element. And we define the set, which is denoted by G of M, of partially invertible elements in this algebra, such that there exists element, sorry, because it should be. Okay, it written in this way. Okay, because the group is the group already taken as invertible elements, so this element norm module of X should be element invertible. And the projection, the support of this element, this is self-adjoint, so left and right projections are equivalent. So we can write as S, and P is support of this element. Again, when we will think about operators, in order to have this groupoid of partially invertible element, we can think about operators which have a closed rank. So we have remarked that this groupoid, this set, which which is given in this way, is not the whole W star algebra in general case. For this set, we define the groupoid structure so as source map is given by right support and target by left support. The product we can define for two elements for which, of course, source and target are equal. The identity section is just inclusion map, and inverse map is defined in this way. So in order to have inverse element for one from this groupoid, we should take polar decomposition and use this formula. And we can quite easily check that this map if the groupoid structure on this set G, of course, over lattice of projections of this. In the next part, this inverse map, I will denote it by power minus one instead of theta. Thanks.
What is interesting?
We, of course, need the D groupoid structure, but this structural maps given in previous slide are not continuous with respect and natural topology considered in W star algebra. For example, we of course consider weak topology because W star algebra is closed with respect to this weak topology. We can in a natural way consider the norm topology. And between these two norms, one considers the several different norms, but these maps are not continuous with respect to the different these topologies. So, but this groupoid possesses the structure of the groupoid because we have built this chart which defines a difference and this chart which defines this differential structure on this. So in order to do this, we take meeting for a fixed, so for fixed, for any fixed projection. From this lattice, we can take the set of projections denoted by pi, pi pi, and such that there exists the composition of W star algebra M for direct sum of such modules or such spaces, Qm plus 1 minus Pm. And then we can decompose this element P with respect to this splitting. We have elements x pi and y pi, such that one is element from Qm and the other is element from 1 minus Pm. Then we can define maps. Sigma P is given from P pi to this part. In groupoid language, this denotes the arrows which are which go from projection P to projection Q. And this part of this groupoid is subset of subspace in M in this form. And the second one, phi pi, is given this way. And with respect such to maps, we can write that sigma of Q is this element and sigma of Q is the second one. This sigma is a section with respect to the target map, and the map phi is bijection from this set onto the Banach space 1 minus Pn. For such map, we can calculate transition maps. They are in this form. And we can write the proposition that such constructed family of charts defines a complex analytic atlas on lattice of projections. And this atlas is modeled by the family of Banach spaces is form, where P is projection from the lattice of algebra. And we have remark that when two projections are equivalent with respect to Neumann relation. That means that there exists the partial isometry for which we can obtain by action on the other. So that condition means that P and P prime are connected by partial isometry. Then such spaces are isomorphic. If not, then not. So what is special thing here in this construction that the whole groupoid is modeled on different Banach spaces. So, not groupoid, in this case we have only for lattice this construction. For the whole the set of arrows we have next one. So for the set of arrows we should take two projections and open set which is defined this way, and the image of this is given in as a splitting of such spaces. It is a little bit technical, so it's not easy to follow. So, the map is given in this form. So we have, what is important here, that we have three coordinates for any element of this G of M. We have three coordinates, and these coordinates are belonging for such spaces. Yes, it's only. We of course can calculate the transition maps, etc., and we can write the following theorem. That this groupoid is a complex analytic Banach groupoid. So Banach means that is modeled on different Banach spaces, and the groupoid that all structural maps in this groupoid are continuous, but continuous in this different structure, which was given. And one more condition, this condition for Hausdorff manifold. So we have also proved that the set of arrow is Hausdorff manifold, and then alpha L of M is also a submanifold of this, and this is enough for us to be sure that this groupoid is Banach groupoid, because we use the definition of Kirill-McKenzie in which this manifold should be Hausdorff. Christian said us that Hausdorff condition is not necessary. It's enough foliation, but I cannot understand the difference between this foliation. It's not my subject. Okay.
Sorry, but if M is a set of bounded operators, then you get the press hand, right?
Yes.
The grass
science, yes.
It's different dimension.
Yes.
The dimension is exactly the orbit, right?
It depends on the orbit, because when projections are finite rank, so it is divided for this part for any rank, and for infinity it's a little bit complicated. We have three or four places. Yes. Codimension can be a finite or infinite. So, but in this groupoid, what is important for us, that we can restrict only for one subgroupoid of this groupoid, which is over the orbit of one projection P, is the set of such projection which are equivalent with respect to this action of partial isometry. And when we take all arrows which connect this projection, we of course obtain a subgroupoid of this groupoid. And of course, this is also a Banach groupoid, and it's closed open. So we restrict our consideration to such subgroupoid, which is of course. And What is important because of this construction? This subgroupoid is transitive. That means that between every two object of each, there exists some arrow. Yes, and we have some general theory theorem from Lie groupoids that every transitive Lie groupoid is isomorphic with some gauge groupoid of some principal bundle. And in this case, we can construct this bundle. In order to do it, it's enough to take the source fiber, the fiber with respect source map of element P0, fixed projection P0. And in groupoid theory, for example, in the book of Brown, topological and I don't remember, topological groupoids, this set is called star. But in differential languages, we call this fiber. So we take this set as the total space of principal bundle on which with the action of group G0, G0 will be the group, which is a group of a group of invertible elements of W star algebra P0 and P0. And of course, we have free right action of this group on this total space and also on Cartesian product of this the same space. And right action is defined by right multiplication, respectively, on one and the other total space. And we can take the quotient groupoid of this pair groupoid divided by G0 action. And we have in this way only the gauge groupoid, which is associated to G0 principal bundle P0 over the lattice, because manifold P0 divided by G0 is isomorphic by lattice of this point P0. So this isomorphism is given by such maps, and we have this way isomorphism of Banach. So this construction with isometry between these two Lie groupoids is quite important for us, because this is the way for combine these two objects, one in W groupoid of elements of W star algebra and the second one the bundle. What is algebraic of groupoids? So we have, we of course know the definition, most maybe this more abstract definition, that the algebraic on manifold is a vector bundle, satisfies such condition. But for me, the most important is most useful for today's consideration is that one. We will consider algebraic of groupoid, and in order to have it, we should consider on the fibers, source fibers given from element target G and source G. So this notation, I don't know, it's written here, that by Gn, we denoted the fiber with respect source map in this point. So we have two fibers, and we consider right translation given by just multiplication on the right hand side by element G. We take tangent to this operation, and we consider the bundle tangent to this fiber, tangent to this fiber given by map S, and this is an involutive sub-bundle, and next we take R invariant sections of this, which form the sub-algebra of tangents bundle to the group, and the section given in this bundle is defined by its restriction to the set of E of M in the group G, where epsilon is identity map. And what is the algebraic of groupoid? It's a vector bundle over M, which is gives from this. It's just bundle, and the anchor map is given as tangent map to target map in groupoid G, restricted to element of space. And in this algebraic, we can define the bracket for this section, which is given as bracket for these sections by restriction to the base. And we have factorial correspondence between the point and in its algebraic. So we know that on one side, so from the point we have can algebraic. So we can write for this groupoid, we can write such exact sequence in the middle of this groupoid of partial invertible elements of W star algebra. Here we have a pair groupoid of lattice of projections, and here we have inner groupoid. Inner groupoid is groupoid formed from arrows for which source and target map are equal, so it is called isotropy group over this projection one. So this is the family of isotropy group, of bundle of isotropy group over this lattice. And this groupoid is totally intransitive subgroupoid of this one, because between every projections we have not connection. We have only arrows which are going from this point to back. And because of this functorial correspondence between points and algebraics, we can write also the exact sequence for algebraics of and of this groupoid, and we can also write the E bracket on the section of it. But what is important, we do it in coordinates given by this differential structure. So the elements of it, you have to remember that this structure, the elements of this structure are elements from subspaces of M. And when we are thinking about operators, so this element can be operators, and they are not commutative. It's important. Okay, the next huge subject. How much time do I still have? 20 minutes? Okay. In order to show some relationship between some object in W star algebra, we will use the VB groupoid and dualization of VB groupoid in sense of definition which is given in Kirill McKenzie book. If you know, for example, the part of four double vector bundles, this is a little bit in the same manner. So you can think about this in this way. So we define VB groupoid. What is VB groupoid? VB groupoid is a structure which contains two groupoids. Here we have here written structural maps and two bundles, vector bundles, of course. So we have VB groupoid vector bundles, for which this diagram is of course commutative, and additional these maps source, target, identity, multiplication, inversion in these groupoids are vector bundle morphisms, and this map given on omega defined in this way is surjective summation, and additionally it holds interchange law which is given in this form. And in V groupoid, the left part we will change according to dualization procedure. We will change to the groupoid dual to the original, which is given in this way. So by K omega, we define the core of this VB groupoid. So the core is defined by the set of such elements from groupoid omega, for which this source is going to a zero section of this bundle, and source is here. And source was here. Source is going to zero section of this bundle, and with respect to this map here, this projection in this bundle is going to one identity element in this groupoid. This is the core of this groupoid, and after dualization, we obtain the following structure. So instead of omega, we put omega star, so dual to omega, and instead of the base of omega, we put dual to core. Dual to core. And it is known that this on the left hand side of this diagram will be also void with structural maps defined in this way. So target source and elastic component. And it is known as dualization of and example. Fundamental example is, of course, tangent prolongation. So when we can groupoid G over M, we can take on the left hand side of this diagram tangent to it. So it is also groupoid. And we have here just tangent bundle to this manifold. So we have projection of the base. And what is the core in this case? In this case, we can calculate that the core is algebraic of this groupoid G. And after dualization, we obtain what? So cotangent to this, and dual to algebraic as a base. For groupoid given just as the group, we know of course what is algebraic because it's semi algebra, but we can check quite easy from this diagram that everything is working. Oh. Okay, so we can write here cotangent to tangent to group and dual to algebra, the algebra of this group. And the next important example, for because it's very useful for us, if we take per groupoid and again tangent prolongation of it, so we put tangent functor to this manifold, we obtain such VB groupoid, and we can check that core of it is the set of such elements in coordinates. So we can write that it's isomorphic with tangent to P. And we can write this way dualization of its groupoid, cotangent bundle to this pair, and cotangent bundle. And what is interesting here, the dual groupoid to pair groupoid is not a pair groupoid. Because in these structural maps, a tangent map changed the sign. So it's almost dual pair by isomorphism, but not exactly. Okay, the next object in this matter, we can consider, we can write such short exact sequence of tangent bundles. So we have tangent to P0, vertical part, which is defined as kernel of projection of this bundle, and this manifold, which is divided by the action of T of algebra, the algebra of G0. And what is important here in this moment? So we will use the action of tangent bundle. We know that this is tangent bundle to the group, yes? But we would like to use action of some group on some bundle on TP0. So what is interesting that we have to know that tangent bundle of group possess the natural structure of group. It's quite easy, right? Because it's enough to take for multiplication G, for example, take only tangent factor to this multiplication, and we can obtain this formula. So, and as a bundle, it's we have utilization of this, and also for this group structure, we can write that it is isomorphic with the product, which is zero times algebra of this group. So we can divide by it by some isomorphism. It works, and after dividing this short exact sequence by G0, because here we have the action and once more by G0, here we obtain the action of TG0. We obtain such short exact sequence of Banach vector bundles, but additionally this is known, and this is called the Attia sequence of the principal bundle, this one. So we obtain this Attia sequence by some kind of quite natural operation. By the same way, we obtain the short exact sequence of the bundle P0 times P0, and we can build such diagram. And of course, we again obtain a Attia sequence of principal bundle with respect to the G0 action, pi for bundle P0 times P0. Okay, and we will also consider PB groupoid, which is tangent to the pair groupoid. We already know how is dualization of it, but we also need a vertical part of this bundle. So when we take vertical part of this bundle, we can write such short exact sequence of such VB groupoids. So on the previous slide, it was sequence for bundles, and then now we have short exact sequence of VB groupoids. And every of VB groupoid, look, we have short exact sequence, but VB groupoids needs to have the other part, yes, because it's diagram. So on the right hand side of every part of this should be a pair groupoid. And we can use realization of the vertical bundle of this bundle. So we can write this again. And the most important thing, one of N for today, we will once more. We have short exact sequence of VB groupoids. So you have to remember that here we have the second part, which is here, the pair groupoid. And we will dualize one of them with sense of dualization of the point. So we obtain on the middle part, sorry, it is written in the whole diagram, in the original form, and we will dualize this in sense of VB groupoids. So here we have dualization of the middle one. Here, dualization of the left hand side because we have a star, so it changed the direction of the arrow. And here we have dualization of the right. And we can observe that what we have After dualization, we have here in every groupoid, in every element, we have gauge groupoid, and in the front of this diagram, we have a short exact sequence of Poisson bundles, which is dual to the Atiyah sequence of this principal bundle. Yes?
You have 5 minutes.
Six. Okay. And some small, not small term, not important term. We know the structure of cotangent bundle. So this groupoid, which is given in that diagram, is the symplectic groupoid of the Poisson manifold. That one, the symplectic groupoid, that one is subgroupoid, as well as symplectic leaf of the Poisson groupoid, that one. And momentum map, which is given in this way, in this phase. For this momentum map, this orbit of zero element, one can consider as orbit of the standard action of the groupoid, that one, on this phase. It was in finite dimensional phase. So what we obtain in infinite dimensional phase. So instead of, because of we have W star algebra, we can take the predual to it, because you know that it exists. And we have such properties that for any predual bundles, any predual bundle is element is a bundle of dual to it, and the action, the multiplication for elements of dual or predual doesn't matter. Here I have for dual multiplication. Is given this way. When we act on the right hand side by multiply elements from predual, we still are in predual. So we can repeat our consideration to predual bundles, and we obtain the same. The same diagrams for this situation. But here, because of this problem with predual, which was given by Daniel Bertica, we can take only weak symplectic structure on the precotangent bundle, which is given by symplectic form given in this way. And this map defines the bundle morphism, which is quasi immersion. In which we obtain only sub bundle in cotangent bundle to it. Quasi sub bundle, quasi Banach sub bundle, it means that. They're not necessarily exist the Banach complement to Banach subspace. And for example, on pre cotangent bundle of T star P0, we can define the Poisson bracket, but only for function. It is important thing for which this condition is satisfied, because the pairing should have sense. So in order to do it, we have to suppose that we will have only such function. And Because of this condition, we define the set of this smooth function of this bundle this type zero, for which this differential element is element from pre-dual to MP0. And we have several propositions. Maybe I skip this. We can write this structure, these formulas for sub-Poisson bracket for these bundles. And again, it's important that in this description we use these coordinates from differential structure. And the aim of my talk is this picture, for which we repeat our consideration for pre-dualization of these points, which we have defined in the beginning. So the picture is almost the same, according to fact that star is gone from is up, not up, but on the lower. But for the whole structure, important is fact that we have in this diagram, in the front of this diagram, so in this part, because here, look, we have again a gauge groupoid of the principal bundle, but here we have subgroupoids of the corresponding horizontal arrows of and corresponding arrows of this diagram define some Poisson morphism between of them. And we, for example, can also write formula for Poisson bracket in this part. We can write formulas for every element in this diagram, but here I show only not all, of course, but in order to show that in this manner we can calculate this reduct. If somebody would like the additional definition, like appendix for this sub-Poisson point, I will not explain. So thank you for attention.
Thank you, Anita, for the nice talk. I think we have time for some quick questions. Joao, anything online?
Not right now, but maybe let's wait for some few seconds just in case. I do not see one here, so I give it.
Then I will move to questions from Vienna.
Yes, I have a question because at the beginning you were in the complex case, you had complex Banach manifold.
Yes, because groupoid of partially invertible element is complex Banach groupoid, and this groupoid, which is considered by Daniel Beltica, a groupoid of partial isometries, is real. Real Banach groupoid in sense of definition given by, for example, Bourbaki book.
Yes, but the Grassmannian or the projection, this should be complex, right? I mean, I make the analogy in the case of bounded operators or matrices. So you have
So projections are the set of the manifold of projection is complex.
Sure. Yes.
Always.
Yes, exactly. And then you have pairs of projection, right?
Yes.
So this is also complex. And on the other side, you have.
But we have for partial isometry, we have restriction. So this is.
Yes, I know. But anyway, this should. On the other side, you have also the a tangent or the cotangent or precotangent of this set of projection or Grassmannian, and this is complex in another way. And just
for the bigger one, point.
Yes. And then I was just wondering if these two complex structures are like compatible in some sense, because I have in mind either the finite dimensional case or the case of Grassmannian in a Hilbert space. So there you have a hyperkeller structure, in fact, in the tangent space of the Grassmannians.
Hyperkeller?
Yes.
So maybe Tomasz will be speaking.
Yes, he knows this also.
Today?
I was just wondering if this two, because at some point you say this is not linear, this antilinear or something. And in this construction of hyperkeller structures, there was also a map which was not.
I don't know if
you don't know if it's, this is.
I have to
something
check
yeah.
Something.
Thank you.
Okay, let's maybe postpone for discussions. And we have a break until. Yeah, so let's take a 15-minute break. We resume at 1:35.